In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about aggregation switch in IMS network. We will discuss about access network topology, general hardware of S9306 switch, the interfaces available, and how to monitor the port link connectivity status with the help of U2000 EMS system. This is the general access network architecture in NG and IMS network. All the LNG and broadband network is connected to IMS via aggregation switches and MPLS PE routers. Let's log in to U2000. After login, the workbench will appear. We'll go to main topology and browse to the site where our aggregation switches are located. We can find here we have two main aggregation switches at two locations. One aggregation switch is here and another one is here. Right click on any, go to the any explorer. This is how S9306 switch hardware looks like. S9306 has four kind of boards, which are power boards, CMU, central monitoring unit, LPU, line processing unit, and MPU board. Here in the bottom we have two power boards and two CMU boards. CMU connector type is RJ45. It works in hot standby mode. You can see one is normal, other one is standby normal. CMU monitors and manages the power modules and fan modules. We have four LPU boards at 1, 2, 3 and slot number 4. We have two type of LPU boards, 48 port and 24 port. LPU, that is line processing unit, processes packets and provides service interfaces. At slot 7 and 8, we can see MPU boards or SRU board. SRU is the control board. It is core of the system. It controls and switches data. SRU can be expanded to include the clock module. SRU forwards data on the data plane, and their data switching units implement load balancing. The two SRU work in 1+1 hot standby redundancy mode. The SRU is hot swappable. Before removing the active SRU, we should perform an active standby switchover. It has console port, Ethernet port, and two clock ports. Console connector is RJ45. And we can connect to the console port through RS232 serial cable. VTH port we can connect using Telnet or SSH. Clock connector type is also RJ45. Clock port can work in time synchronization mode and clock synchronization mode. S9306 supports port mirroring and flow mirroring. We can do port mirroring on Ethernet port to monitor another port. And by connecting a host with Ethernet port, we can examine all the packets going inside and outside. In this way, we can observe all the packets input and output from switch. The mirroring function provides basic traffic detection, fault allocation, and data analysis. Now we will see port connectivity and link status. Click on the LPU board, then port information. Here we can see where each port is connected and what is the status, whether it is up or down. If the port administrative status is up but the operating status is down, then this is commonly because of various reasons, like the devices are powered off or the cable between the interface is not connected properly, or the Ethernet interfaces are manually shut down, or the twisted pair or fiber between the interfaces is too long and the attenuation is very high. or it may be due to the duplex modes or the speed of the local and remote interfaces are different, or it may be due to the interfaces or interface modules or devices are faulty. So we should check all these points to resolve the issue. If the operating status of an interface displays up, that means interface is working properly. Now we will see other aggregation switch, which is here. The physical architecture already explained is same: two power boards, two CMU boards, four LPU boards, and two MPU boards. We will see where the interfaces are connected. As you can see, port 1010 is going to the aggregation switch in 105. We have seen earlier aggregation LAN switch 1. We will go back and check the port there. Here in aggregation switch 1, 105 is connected to aggregation LAN switch 2 in 1010. See, it is at the same port. So this is how we can trace and monitor the network using EMS. So we have seen here the basic access network topology, S9306 architecture, and how to monitor the interfaces. Thank you.